Hey guys, so in this video, I'd like to give my perspective on the idea of skilling and attempt to be as least concise as I can be, because at times I tend to speak very briefly. So approximately 4 years ago now, Acid Soul came out with a video called Grinding Mentality Revisited, where he references a concept he developed early on in his 200 mil mining grind and expands upon it. To give a little context, this idea summarizes the adaption towards skilling one has when they've started the trek of a lengthy grinding-based goal. In his own experience, Acid describes a feeling of numbness, but at the same time satisfaction from sticking with his daily routines. My mind had adjusted to the routine, and sticking to them felt very rewarding. It became like a flow phase, where I just flew past the last few months of mining. It was for sure the most amazing experience I've had with any game, in his own words. This idea of enjoyment from grinding tends to have a severely negative connotation surrounding the phenomenon, which is typically shared by the quote-unquote outsiders of the concept. People who haven't had personal experience with our particular form of repetitive behavior, for example, might be leaving me a nasty YouTube comment at this very moment. Beyond this game, though, everyone has had some form of experience with excessive repetition in their life in which they've even felt rewarded from. While we all naturally seek the desire for dynamism in our daily lives, as Acid said, the repetitive gameplay is a way of holding on to familiarity and stability. So on a side note, I don't think this game is a negative distraction from our daily life occurrences of consistent uncertainty. Perhaps for some of us, it keeps us sane. As I was saying though, I think a player's motive towards the game is something that is seldom accounted for when whether you can say they're an excellent player or not. While EHP is the orthodox metric in which the caliber of success a player is measured, I feel that there is something to playing for the sake of enjoyment. For some examples of why people play for truly absurd amounts of time can be for sharing their personal progress with others, captivating the sense of overcoming difficult challenges that they place upon themselves, certain social factors such as peer pressure, obtaining recognition for something, or even some false sense of higher social status amongst like-minded players, or even solely for the sake of getting to the level of gameplay that they look up to. I don't mean this in a negative way whatsoever, because for one, me myself am guilty of those things, but nearly 100% of skillers most likely grind XP for one of those reasons, and again, that's not a bad thing. If nobody was looking for anyone's approval, no one would accomplish anything. Whether it being trying to get your boss's attention or your professor, it will inherently make you accomplish more than what you initially thought you could. Some people try to argue this meaningless grind gives a false sense of accomplishment, but from my own perspective, it has made me question what exactly I can't do, which is ultimately much more beneficial than anything else I've learned. Deliberately exposing yourself to discomfort has sort of become a trendy thing these days, from what I've noticed. While in most cases that applies to trying new things, and what I'm referring to is the polar opposite, I'm just trying to say that nothing is completely meaningless. As I said previously, I think 100% of OSRS players play for one of those reasons that I mentioned, but I think there are some who play for another reason. Pure enjoyment of grinding. I believe most of us play for that purpose, but not to its entirety. I'm not referring to enjoying a method or even a specific skill, just the pure routine-based repetition for what it is. These players, my own opinion, are greater than any other player that I've ever played. Grinding is the essence of skilling, and that's as comprehensive as it gets. Stating once again, it's hard to judge someone's motives, even if they're telling you themselves why it is they play the game. I personally couldn't give you the exact reason I play, although I'm assuming it's some sort of combination of nostalgia, an excuse for a hobby, combined with all of those other things I mentioned. While in some cases it can be rude to name names, there are three players who come to mind who seem to fit this criteria based off of the things I've observed about them, and I'm calling them out because I think that they are excellent players. The obvious fit is Acid Soul. While he claims he plays for others' approval in multiple videos, I'd like to think he, out of most of us, truly enjoyed the 200 mil mining grind for what it was. Second is a player named Kepi42. If you're unfamiliar with him, he was the fifth player to reach 200 mil agility XP on OSRS, first ultimate Iron Man to 200 mil agility, first 200 mil agility on Deadman mode, and I believe he had 200 mil agility on RS3, but I can't confirm since he's been inactive so long. He was removed from the RS3 high scores at this point. But more importantly, I'd like to point out his 138.1 mil crafting XP. This might seem sort of arbitrary, but there is literally no reason to do that besides simply enjoying the grind. I'm sure most of you haven't even heard of him, and that's why I bring him up. His method of crafting was blowing glass on Entrana by picking up seaweed respawns for about 25k an hour crafting XP. Definitely one of the most impressive skillers in my book. Lastly, I'd like to mention mid-level Skilla, and while I'm sure most of you have probably heard of him, especially if you're subscribed to me, I would be willing to bet if there was not a single person that played RuneScape, he would still be doing what he's doing. If you're unfamiliar with this player, his account is a 3 combat free to play only Ultimate Iron Man. Let me take a quick gasp of air before this. Min has accomplished 99 mining, smithing, and crafting, all through walking between the crafting guild and Falador Furnace by mining gold, smelting it, and crafting it for about 8k an hour crafting XP, give or take a couple thousand XP. After a certain point, he hit 99 crafting before smithing, so instead of crafting the gold, he would simply smelt it and drop it on the way back to the guild for about 4k an hour smithing XP. Smithing by itself probably took him around 4,000 hours to complete. In addition to that, he has completed 200 mil fishing and cooking XP by 3-tick snow fishing an inventory of fish, then cooking them. This took around 3,000 hours. In addition to that, he has recently completed 200 mil woodcutting and fire making by 3-tick snow woodcutting an inventory of logs and burning them. This also took around 3,000 hours. And lastly, in addition to this, he is currently going for 25 mil runecraft XP by claiming air talismans from the Lumberj Duke using the Shanty Pass to Port Sarum teleport, crafting air tiaras at the air altar, then suiciding from the nearby highwayman to repeat the process for about 2.5k per hour runecraft XP. And yep, that's correct. He's about to attempt a runecraft for 10,000 hours. So, in conclusion, I'd like to assume players who possess this quality of unfazed consistency and perfected routine for their end goal truly have mastered the grinding mentality. While they don't seek anyone's approval for doing these things, they certainly hold mine.